As more players from the Far East emerge on the global scene, do you think there is or will be a place in the calendar for a biennial match between the winners of the Ryder Cup and an Asian team?
Yes, I think, you know, with the Americans already playing Ryder Cup and then President's Cup in the years that Ryder Cup's not played, they're pretty much up to here with team golf, and getting working it into the calendar these days is the hardest thing. You know, since FedEx Cup's come on the scene, the Ryder Cup's dates got pushed back. We all who are close to golf know that this is the thing that's happening. So it'd be difficult to schedule, but I definitely think we're going to see a surge of Asian players coming up. I think nothing stays the same, and I think that's going to be the next biggest thing in men's golf. As golf develops in Asia, as it's doing now very quickly, and it will continue to develop in China especially, in the near future, I think we'll see a lot more Asian players other than Mr. Yang being major champions.
Going back in time, when you were at the peak of your powers on the golf course, there weren't too many Asian players taking part in the majors. One of the exceptions was Mr. Liu Luanghan. What are your recollections of him, especially in the 1971 Open Championship at Royal Birkdale, when you were both narrowly pipped to the title by Lee Trevino?
Well, I remember Mr. Liu from playing in the Far East. We played at Changi Golf Club in Singapore, exhibition match in 1967. But I got to know him early, is what I'm saying. And I especially remember 71, because he hit his second shot on the last hole and hit a woman in the head, knocked her down on the ground. She was out. And his ball bounced back into the fairway. He proceeded to get it on the green and in the hole for a birdie to pip me into, you know, I finished third and he finished second. But he had this wonderful way with him of pulling the hat off and this wonderful smile. And then the next year he came, the hat was gone. And I never understood that. And that was one of the memories that stay with me from Mr. Liu. He'd created this aura with the hat. You know, all he had to do was that and smile, and he had them. And then the hat disappeared the next year. I thought that was quite odd. But it was sort of way before that kind of advice of PR came to players, I suppose.
One of your rare playing appearances in Asia came in the Hong Kong Open in 1979, an event won by a rising Australian star by the name of Greg Norman. Was that the first time you'd encountered the shark, and are there any particular memories from that week?
Yeah, around that time we played an event at the Manchester Open in Manchester, England, and Greg appeared there as a 20-year-old, I think, and that was the first time I met him. I can't remember whether we played together, but I met him on the first tee there, and he was a strapping big fellow with a white mop of hair, you know, and a manager who used to have a pipe. I can't remember his name, but this pipe had a massive bowl on it, and he was the guy who invented the logo for him, you know, the shark, which I thought was actually at the time, I have to say, you know, what crazy, you know, this, who the hell's going to listen to a, you know, the shark? What a thing to pluck out of the sky, you know, because he was from Australia and the shark and all the rest of it. But boy, was I proven wrong. And you know, the marketing and advertising world, he made fortunes, of course, and he was a tremendous asset to the game of golf as time went by. But that was the first time I met him in Manchester.
As for the present, what do you make of the European Tour's ever-increasing encroachment into Asia? If you were playing now, would you embrace the travel, or would you rather the European Tour remains in Europe?
Well, you know, I don't know when China was last in Europe, so, you know, I'm perplexed. I'm as perplexed as most people. And I certainly would like to see the European Tour stay in Europe. I don't believe, you know, we've got some very powerful companies, corporations in Europe, and I can't believe that between them, they couldn't support a tour that could happen there. Of course, by the time you take the tour to Asia, you compromise the players. The Asians have to have more players involved in the tour. And as I said earlier, I think the next big move in this game will be Asian players' improvement, because they've got a tremendous work ethic. And we're still, and anybody that's doing golf course design as I am now, know there's going to be huge growth at that side of the world. And to have taken the European tour, and of course either the name's wrong or the concept's wrong, I mean, I think we should be looking at changing the name if they're going to keep going where they're going. But you know, I think it's going to compromise things as the Asian players jump on this thing. And I don't think there's any doubt that we'll see the male golfers doing what the female golfers have done ahead of them, and starting to win more major championships and become a real factor in at the sharp end of the game. We'll be right back.